Hi everyone, good evening, welcome, hi Lily, hello Zaira, Wendy, hello, hi Carlos,
good evening
everyone, welcome, good to see
good
you,
good evening teacher,
hi Anna, welcome, yeah. Okay, well, I'm going to take the attendance first, and then I'm going to tell you what we will do first. So I'm going to start with Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Ana Lilian.
Present.
Brian Javier. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Okay. Eli. Elizabeth Martinez. Jose Arnoldo.
I'm here. Good night.
Jose. Hello. Good evening. Jose Galileo.
Good evening, ma'am. Present.
Thank you. And then Jonathan Vigil.
Present, miss.
Jose Rodriguez. Ah, okay. Okay, Jonathan. That's fine. Juan Carlos Rivas. Laura Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Okay. María Concepción.
Present.
María Elena.
Present.
Thank you. Mayra Moreno. Nelson Gabarrete.
I'm here, miss.
Omar Francisco. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Zaira Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Wendy Maribel.
Present, teacher.
Okay, and Jenny Santos. Jenny, not here yet. Okay, so now that I have you here, we're going to start the class with one activity. I want you to tell me one or two things you are going to do in the next days of December. One activity, one or two activities you are going to do in the next days of December. Que me digan una o dos actividades que harán en los siguientes días de este mes, December. I'm going to give you a moment and then we will listen to some of you. So let me know when you're ready. Two activities or two plans you have for this month. Okay, is there anybody ready? Or not yet? No, okay. Arnoldo, can you tell us the activities you have planned for December? Just remember to activate the microphone.
Yes, we will hold a meeting with my work team and with my family. We will prepare tamales for the new year.
Tamales. Ah, okay. Are you going to prepare them too? Are you going to cook?
Yes. Yes.
Ah, okay.
Pig.
Ah, pig tamales.
Pig tamales. Hen tamales.
Ah, okay. That sounds yummy. Thank you, Arnoldo.
And sweet tamales with pasas, with raisins.
A lot of food. And different options. Okay.
Many ways.
Yes, there are different options. But it's nice that you cook with the family. Laura, what about you? Tell me two plans, two activities you will have in December.
I will visit my family in the San Vicente. And I will help to, to cook my sister.
You will help.
In Christmas.
You're going to cook too.
Ah, sí. No. Yo ayudaré. O sea, I will help to cook my sister.
Ah, okay. And
the pavo.
Turkey.
No sé. Turkey.
Ah, yes. Okay.
Yes.
Those are your plans. Okay, Laura.
Yes.
Thank you. And Wendy, are you ready? Two plans you have.
Yes. I have help to my mother. Cook. Cook. Ham.
Ham. Yes.
Ham and salad. I work.
And work. Okay. Okay, but you enjoy it.
Yes. Enjoy. Ah, my cousin. Cousin is Sorina.
Niece.
My cousin visit me.
My niece. Visit me. Cousin es my prima y niece.
Ah, no. Niece. My niece. My niece visit me and my brother and his wife.
Brother and his wife. Correct.
Yeah.
Okay, a family reunion. Thank you, Wendy.
Yes.
Are you ready, Lily? You can also send it in the chat, guys. That's, and I will read your message if you have it. Yes, Lily. The microphone, Lily. We don't hear you, Lily. El micrófono, Lily. No le escuchamos. Okay, then let's continue with Zaira. I think she has issues with the internet.
A teacher,
okay. One moment, Zaira. Yes, yes, now I hear you.
Okay. I will attend a co-worker when he and go shopping on the weekend.
And you will go shopping. Ah, okay. Yeah. When? Next week or this Saturday? When are you going to go shopping?
Saturday.
Saturday.
Yes.
Okay. Enjoy. Buy a lot of things.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Lily. Yes, Zaira, please tell us.
I am going to a Christmas dinner next Friday.
Next Friday.
I am going to visit my grandfather
on the 24th, yes. Okay, good plans, Zaira, interesting. Have fun as well. Thank you. Carlos, I checked you sent the message. You will meet for dinner at Christmas with your family, all your family members.
Yes.
How many people are going to be there?
20
people.
20 people.
Yes. Oh, okay. It's a big group. It's a big yes. group of people. You have to prepare a lot of food for everyone. Yeah, because it's a big group. So it's going to be a very good time. Okay, Carlos, thank you. Thank Nelson, you. Are you ready? Do you have your comment?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
The end of the year, I will go to visit parents. Mm-hmm. I will visit the beach.
Mm-hmm. When? When are you going to visit the beach?
It's the end of the year.
Ah, okay, December 31st.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Good plans too. I imagine the beach is going to be crowded, right? Me imagino que va a estar bien llena la playa. It's going to be crowded. So.
Yes. Maximamente el primero, el primero.
Uh-huh,
siempre se yeah. llenas, fin de año, sí.
Yeah, I wanted to go too, but I don't think so. Because of that, because my family doesn't like to go. A mi familia no le gusta salir on the okay. holidays. Because it's kind of dangerous sometimes. And a lot of people and drunk people too. So you have to be careful. You have to take some yes. precautions. Tiene que tener cuidado. Okay, yes. Nelson. Thank you. Let's continue with Galileo. Galileo, what are your plans? Or can you tell us one plan you have?
Before I need to sell something.
Yes.
I agree with your family. I think the same about people are drunk in the street, mm-hmm. in the road. I think the same.
Uh-huh, yeah. Maybe with this new law, it's going to be lower. Tal vez con la nueva ley que hay, creo que ya todos la conocen. About the beer.
Yeah.
Uh-huh, lo de la cerveza con, no sé, no me recuerdo bien si es una o dos. Dos, creo. If you have drunk like two bottles of beer, you can go to jail, tal vez. Maybe that is going to help. Yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe, right? Maybe not. Pero ya con eso ya les va a dar un poquito de miedo a algunos.
Yes, I think maybe the percent will going to down.
Uh-huh.
The percent of
it could go down.
Yes.
Hopefully. And yes, yeah. what about you? Are you going to stay at home or?
Okay, I am going to buy toys to Huguetón on December 18th to my little son.
December 18th? The second night,
December 18th.
Mm-hmm.
The second activity is I am going to buy pyrotechnics fire with my
fireworks.
Children. Fireworks.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
fireworks. I'm sorry, ma'am. I don't know what. I can write it.
Ah, I can send it in the chat. Fireworks.
Fireworks.
Mm-hmm.
Fireworks. Is the pyrotechnics fireworks or solo fireworks?
Firework, that's the general word we use.
Okay.
Uh-huh. That's the one you can use, fireworks.
Okay. So I am going to buy a fireworks with my children on December 23.
Okay, next week.
That are the two activities I am planning.
Thank you, Galileo. You can say those in that case. Those oh. are the
yeah.
activity. That
Thank
just for one. Okay, thank you, Galileo. And let's listen to Juan Carlos. I noticed you sent it in the chat, but can you read it, please?
Okay, These holidays I enjoy with my complete family because my niece come back from Spain. And my brother usually cooks, bake turkey, a salad, and drink a bottle of wine. And at midnight, open the family's present.
I'm okay.
And all drunk.
But remember, don't drive.
Happiness.
A lot of happiness, music, and family. Okay, Juan Carlos, thank you for sharing. Now let's continue with Brian. Brian, can you read it, please?
In my case, teacher, I'm going to work the next week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Until 23.
Uh-huh.
Next, I will stay on the beach for Christmas.
Ah, okay. Is it going to be like a beach house that you're going to stay?
Yes.
Uh-huh. That's cool. It's better like that. Uh-huh. A beach house. También está la palabra flat. That is like a beach house, but that one is expensive or very elegant, very fancy. That is considered, that's considered a flat. También es como una casa, pero es así bien cara.
Oh,
okay. And beach house is like the normal class. That's the normal one. Okay, Brian, thank you. So guys, let's continue. I'm going to share with you the book, and we have an activity about trainings. Yesterday, we talked about trainings, right? Why they are important, the way we learn, different steps to follow to have a training. And in this moment, we're going to have more vocabulary. Ayer estuvimos hablando un poquito sobre trainings. Y mencionábamos cómo funcionan, qué se hace, por qué son importantes. Y en este momento vamos a tener un poquito más de vocabulary about trainings. We have six words. Goal, feedback, budget, knowledge gap, coaching, and qualifications. We have the term and we have the definition. We have to try to find the definition for each term. La idea es que encontremos cuál es la definición para cada palabra. I'm going to give you a moment to read it, and then we will check it together. Les voy a dar un momento para que lo lean, lo analicen, y luego vamos a revisarlo juntos y contestar cualquier duda. Do you have questions for me? Do you have any questions? No? Okay, I'm going to give you a moment, and in about 3 minutes, okay? 3 minutes, we check your answers. In 1 minute, we will start together. Okay, in 1 minute, we check your answers. Okay, so let's begin. Goal. Where is the definition? Wendy, what do you think? Number one, goal. Where do you see it?
An estimation of income and expenses.
It's different, Wendy, but we will check in 1 moment. Es diferente, pero ya lo vamos a ver ahorita. Anne, what about you? What is goal?
It's a desired result or possible outcome.
Okay, thank you, Anna. And Galileo, do you have the same opinion as Anna? No, different. The microphone, Galileo.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I don't have the
number
answer.
One.
But...
Okay. Okay.
I'm sorry.
No problem. Number one is this one here. Yes, a goal is the result. Is goal is like an objective that you have. Okay, that is the meaning of a goal. It's a result that you want to have in the future. So it's like an objective, okay? So yes, Anna, that's the one. Okay, now feedback. Juan Carlos, where do you see the definition? What do you think it is? Feedback.
Helpful information or criticisms about the performance of a person.
Okay, Juan Carlos, thank you. Brian? Do you have the same opinion? Feedback.
I don't know feedback.
No, okay. And you, Carlos? Do you know that one? Feedback?
The same opinion.
The same opinion as Juan Carlos.
Juan Carlos.
That's the one. This is number two. Helpful information, criticism about the performance of a person. Eso es lo que le llamamos retroalimentación. That will be feedback, right? Entonces es información útil o una crítica, ¿verdad? Sobre cómo está alguien ejecutando su trabajo. So, yes, that's feedback. Next one, number three. Arnoldo, do you have an idea? I think he's...
Maybe an estimation of income and expense. Presupuesto.
Budget. Okay, thank you, Arnoldo. And you, Zaira? Budget? Number three? Do you have that one?
It's estimation of income and expense.
Yes. So thank you, Arnoldo and Zaira. That will be number three. And as Arnoldo mentioned, budget, it's what we call presupuesto, right? An estimation. Un estimado sobre lo que sería el income, la ganancia o los gastos. Everything. A budget. Okay, thank you, Zaira. Number four, knowledge gap. Laura, what do you think it is or where is it? Knowledge gap. We have three options. Hay todavía tres.
Okay. Es an irregular balance or what a person should know.
Okay. Thank you, Laura. And you, Oscar, do you have the same opinion, number four? Or what is it for you?
I had the irregular balance of what person should know.
Correct. Thank you. I don't know if you remember that yesterday I told you a little bit about this one. No sé si se recuerdan que ayer la platicamos. Knowledge gap, knowledge es conocimiento, ¿verdad? Un gap es como un espacio, como un vacío, un conocimiento que no está en esa persona y debería de tenerlo. Entonces se le llama knowledge gap. Ese knowledge que no tiene en he or she should have. Okay, thank you. Now number five. Okay, what is your opinion, Lily? Number five, coaching. We have two options. What could it be? Are you there, Lily?
What, teacher?
Coaching, number five. You have this one here, Estela.
Quality that make from a one.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay. Someone suitable.
A particular job. Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. And you, Wendy, coaching?
The process of improving the performance of the project.
That's the one. Uh-huh. Thank you. That will be coaching. Coaching is when you have your boss or your manager giving you some feedback and they tell you how to improve. Es como que tuvieran a su jefe, ¿verdad? Dándoles algunos consejos para que ustedes mejoren. A eso se le llama coaching. Como, digamos, Laura, ¿verdad? You have your job y hay algo que no lo estamos haciendo bien y ya viene su coach o su boss y ya le dice, Laura, haga esto así o hágalo de esta manera. Eso es coaching in English.
Teacher, pero hay coach como de motivación, ¿verdad?
Ajá, puede ser como... En esta misma aplica. It's like motivation y al mismo tiempo ideas to, like tips, como que le den tips para mejorar. Mm-hmm. Como que digamos, no esté vendiendo boletos porque hay algo que no está haciendo bien y ya le dice a su jefe, diga esto, haga lo otro. Entonces ya eso sería como coaching. Mm-hmm.
Como va mejor. Number two, ¿qué significa?
Number two, feedback, retroalimentación. Es como cuando le dan una crítica sobre cómo está trabajando. Eso es feedback, retroalimentación. Uh-huh. Oscar, do you have a, I'm sorry, Laura?
No, iba a hacer un comentario. Es cuando Ajá. usted nos dice, les daré un feedback.
Ah, yes, I use that word.
Cuando Ajá. repasamos la clase, ¿ok?
Ajá, yo les doy feedback, correct. I tell you this. Ya veo que, ajá, ya veo que me pone atención, Laura. Ok, and the last one, number six, qualifications. Do you understand that word, qualifications, qualities that make someone suitable for a particular job? Do you understand that one? Or not that much? Qualifications son como lo que una persona debe de tener para que sea la persona adecuada para ese trabajo, ¿verdad? Le ponen algunas como, como I don't remember this word in Spanish, pero son como que hay unos requerimientos. Arnoldo,
do you... Requisitos, requerimientos.
Ajá, ajá, like requirements. Aptitudes, yes, that could be better. Entonces ya están los requerimientos y si usted los cumple,
cualidades,
qualification, ajá, tiene todo lo que necesita para ese trabajo. You have everything. Ok, entonces todas estas palabras son relacionadas a trainings. Let's see. Nelson, can you read them, please? Just to practice pronunciation. Could you read them? ¿Las puede leer? Solo para practicar pronunciation.
Ok. Well,
goal. It's like como gol, goal, pero en inglés, goal.
Ah, goal.
Yes.
Feedback.
Mm-hmm.
Budget. Knowledge gap.
Knowledge.
Knowledge.
Coaching.
And knowledge. Coaching.
And qualifications.
Qualification.
Uh-huh. Qualifications. Okay. And budget. En la palabra budget, la D es como se omite, no se pronuncia. Solo es budget. Budget.
Ah,
that's the pronunciation.
Budget. Okay. Yes. Budget.
Thank you. Juan Carlos, can you repeat, please?
Goal, feedback, budget, knowledge gap, coaching, qualifications.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Good pronunciation. Okay, I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to ask some questions. We will start with Anna. Anna, question number one. Is it only new employees who need training? Only new employees need training, Anna? What do you think?
Is ¿cómo sería por temporada alta?
But can you give me the context? ¿Temporada alta en qué sentido?
¿Cómo se llama? Empleados nuevos con entrenamiento por la temporada alta.
Maybe you can say on. Okay, hold on. Let me look for a term. Like for holiday seasons, right? When there are more things to do.
Big season, maybe.
Big season, but no, there's another term, but it has slipped my mind. Se me ha ido el término. When I remember, and I will let you know, because I have forgotten. But ahí dice de que si solo los empleados nuevos necesitan training. What do you think? ¿Será que solo los nuevos? ¿Just new employees?
No.
Why no. not?
Pondría todo, pero todo el personal.
All the personal, all the staff require
the training and different areas, the temas.
Topics? Or subjects
and the topics in the quality in the has manufacturing in the hands and safety.
Okay, thank you, Anna. Brian, and you, what is your opinion? The same as Anna, or is it just new employees who need training?
For everyone, teacher.
Why?
Maybe it's important. Take about topic new
About activity, daily routine, and new routine. And maybe new activities, teacher.
Okay, correct. Yes, when there are new activities, we need training. Is there any other comment, an extra or additional comment about that? If not, we continue with question number two. Okay, all right, let's begin with Carlos. You are a manager, right? If I'm not mistaken, and Juan Carlos as well. Okay, the question is, what do you do if you are a manager and an employee comes to you asking for a training? You are a manager and an employee says, Carlos, I want a training. What do you do? ¿Qué haría si un employee, verdad? Usted fuera un manager y un employee le dice que quiere un training. What would you do in a case like that? ¿Qué haría?
I think analysis the training for the people is the better training or say other training.
Ah, okay. So you will check. Depend
for the training, the kind of the training.
Uh-huh. It depends on the necessities of the of the employee. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Carlos. And you, Arnoldo, what would you do?
First step, I analyze the possibility. And then I think about the situation and evaluate some employees for make a training. All employees need training, but not all employees needs the same training.
Correct. It's different.
Some employees need trainings about sales. Others employees need trainings about warehouse or sales techniques. Maybe, for example, in my workplace, every week have we will training for different brands.
Every week,
but don't attend the trainings. All employees, only the employees need learn the techniques for different brands.
Uh-huh. You can say only selected employees. Or another possibility could be appointed. It's the same. Appointed employees. Solo los específicos, ¿verdad? Okay, thank you, Arnoldo, for the comment. In this moment, I'm showing you a TNA, Training Needs Analysis chart. This is a chart, okay, and a sheet with information. Imagine this is what they use to fill out the form for the training. Esta es como una forma que algunas compañías utilizan, ¿verdad? Para cuando alguien necesita training. Like when you go to the East and you fill out the info about you. Así como cuando uno va, digamos, al Seguro Social o otros lugares. Tenemos una form, right, que se llena. Entonces acá está la información que ellos anotan. Employee name, major or big, tasks of the position, training solutions. What other areas would you like to improve? ¿Qué otras áreas podrías mejorar o podría mejorar? Training skills needed, yes or no. TNA, again, training analysis. Don't buy and the name of the person, the trainer. Okay. Entonces, este es como un ejemplo de lo que se necesita o de lo que va en esa forma or document que se da a la persona indicada. The idea is another comprehension activity, es otra actividad de análisis. In this part here, you have the information. Aquí tenemos toda la información que se pondría en esta chart. Y tienen que ver cuál iría para cada lugar. For example, lo primero que necesitamos es el employee name. Have you seen it? No sé si ya lo encontraron. The employee name. Ajá, letter F.
Jimmy Marshall.
Jimmy Marshall. Ajá, entonces ahí quedaría Jimmy Marshall. The idea is that you complete the chart. La idea es que ustedes analicen a dónde iría cada literal. Letter A, letter B, letter C. Y luego lo vamos a analizar together. Is it clear? Do we understand or questions? Okay, no questions. Laura, Wendy, questions? No, no questions. Okay.
Teacher. La parte de arriba está como la estructura de lo que tenemos, o sea, los literales tenemos que llenar el recuadro del formulario.
Ajá.
Okay.
Aquí está todo lo que va a ir en el formulario, pero hay que buscar en dónde va a ir cada uno. Porque dice Jimmy Marshall, otro dice September Saturday 10th. Entonces tiene que buscar a dónde iría cada uno.
Ok.
Ajá.
Thank you, teacher.
If there is a word you don't know, si hay alguna palabra que usted no sepa, let me know. Let me know y yo le trato ahí de ayudar. Handling, no sé si todavía se recuerdan de la palabra handle. Do you remember handle? When you give something with your hands, you handle. Handle es dar algo con las manos, right? Handle credit cards. But in this case, it's like working with credit cards. Handle credit cards is difficult for me. Oh, and guys, grooming. Les iba a decir que era grooming. No sé si sabían qué es eso. But that is your appearance. To have a clean appearance. To have. Right here. To be clean. Okay. It's about your personal appearance. Es sobre la apariencia de una persona. Grooming es lucir bien. Estar impecable. Okay, that is grooming, grooming and appearance, personal appearance. Just one question, Galileo. Did you say high season or big season para temporada alta? High.
High season.
High season. So yes, yes, you were right. That was the one. Yo no oí bien. I heard big season.
No, I said peak. Peak season. But
peak season.
It's a lot in turn. Freight forward. Es un término usado por los que cargan los contenedores, peak season, temporada de carga. Peak. Yo me equivoqué.
Sí, pero era parecida. Es high season. Ana, that's the word para temporada alta. High season and low season is the opposite. I send them the chat.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Arnoldo?
Ready.
You're ready. Okay, cool. And you guys, ¿cómo vamos? Are you done too? Wendy, how are you doing? ¿Qué tal va? Ready. Usted me dijo que quería más comprehension. Entonces, a lot of activities about it. And then we will have some activities about will. That is what we will study in one moment. Okay, let's begin in 1 minute. Vamos a empezar en un minuto. We will start in 1 minute and we check it together. Si no lo han terminado, lo vamos a terminar juntos. We will continue together. Okay, we will continue together. Carlos, the training solution is different. The training solution will be different, but we will check in this moment. The other parts look good. Okay, so let's begin with Mayra. Hi, Mayra. Can you help us with, date. Okay, let's begin with the date.
Date,
letter G, correct,
September.
Saturday
10, supongo.
Yes, that's the one,
yes.
Thank you. Okay, so there it is, we have the date, it will be Saturday the 10th, just one day, that's cool. Okay, let's talk about the provider or the organizer. Who is it going to be? Nelson? Organizer?
Hello, I'm sorry.
Organizer? ¿Quién sería?
Organizer.
¿Quién cree que lo va a proveer? Do you have that one? No sé si terminó ese. The organizer.
Letter B.
Letter B. Kitchen manager.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And let's check with Carlos. The same opinion as Nelson, Carlos. The kitchen manager.
Oh, teacher.
No, what is your opinion?
The organized provides grooming and personal appearance.
Okay, thank you, Carlos. And let's check with Galileo. What is your opinion, Galileo?
I agree with Nelson, letter B.
Letter B, the kitchen manager. Okay, thank you. Laura?
Letter B, teacher, kitchen manager is organizer, provider.
Correct. Well, in this case, it will be the kitchen manager. That's the one. Es el proveedor, el que lo haría, el organizador. Kitchen manager. Okay, thank you. Now let's continue with the next one. Okay, so we will remove that one. We know that it's Jimmy Marshall. And now what about the training solution? What do you think about that one, Zaira? What will be the training solution? Which one, I'm sorry? I don't hear you. Do you hear me, Zaira?
¿Me escucha, teacher?
Yes. What is your opinion?
Letter C.
Practical training in restaurant during off hours. That is the training solution. Thank you. We will put it here. One moment, guys. We're almost done. Ya casi lo terminamos. Okay, so that will be the training solution. Now, Jenny, can you help us with what other areas would you like to improve? What will be the answer?
A, handling red cards being difficult for me.
Okay, that could be one. Or B, okay, let's check. And you, Arnoldo, what do you have? Other areas you would like to improve?
What other areas?
Would you like to improve? Letter D, grooming and personal appearance. That could be one. Estas están parecidas, depende de cómo lo quisieran ver. Podría ser, what other areas would you like to improve? Podría ser eso. Handling cards. But I imagine this one is like the major problem. Podría ser eso, el problema mayor. Okay, and major task of the position. What do you have there, Ana? Major task of the position.
Is letter E.
Letter
service
E.
Service.
That one, right? Okay. Serve other orders, I'm sorry, by picking up and delivering patrons' choices from bar. Okay, thank you. Well, I don't know if you have a question before we go on. No sé si querían.
Y en question de what other in areas is letter A.
Yes, letter A. Incluso podemos agregar la otra. Grooming and appearance. Sure. Both. Both of them.
Okay.
Okay, guys. So we will go on. We will continue. I'm sorry. Do you have other questions?
Yo, teacher.
Laura.
Yo puse en major task of the position, literal D en E, como evaluando esas dos áreas de una sola vez.
Donde dice major
pero
task.
No sé. Major task, las tareas que debemos de, en la posición, ¿verdad? Porque la apariencia se supone que la evalúan porque todos los días tienen que llegar presentables, ¿verdad? Porque decía en el training, habilidades necesarias, yes y no, ¿verdad? Entonces usted evalúa los dos ítems, bueno, pensé, y solo en la mejora sería el literal A, que es Handling Credit Card, que necesita para mí, o sea, pero no sé, teacher.
Okay. Ok, donde dice major tasks of the position es como las actividades más grandes que tiene que hacer en esa posición. Pero si usted pone handling credit cards is difficult for me, esa es como una debilidad.
No, no teacher, como una... esa, ajá, no, esa la puse en what other areas.
Ah, ajá.
Esa está bien. Would you like lo único to... que, ajá, D, E, A, E, en mí.
Y en mí.
Puse, ajá, en mayor tasa de posición.
Ah, ok, ya. Yeah.
Como evalué tu item.
Aunque sea una parte.
Aire. Ajá.
Ah, ok. Yeah, you could leave it like that. Podría quedarle así. That would be fine.
Teacher, puede poner de nuevo la pantallita donde está el ejercicio.
Ok.
Por favor. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to take the attendance and we will continue. We will continue with the class. I'm going to start with Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Ana Lilian.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Brian Javier.
Present, Carlos
Antonio.
Present.
Elizabeth Martínez. José Arnoldo.
Present.
José Galileo.
Present, ma'am.
José Jonathan. José Rodrigo. Juan Carlos. Laura Carolina.
Present.
Okay, thank you. María Concepción. María Elena. Mayra Moreno.
Present, teacher.
Nelson Gabarrete.
I'm here, miss.
Okay, thank you. Omar Francisco.
Present.
Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Zaira Marleni. Wendy Maribel. And Jenny Santos.
Present, teacher.
Okay,
present, teacher.
Thank you.
Yo quería copiar las soluciones.
Sí, se borra cuando cierro la pantalla. It's deleted. I'm sorry. Yes, I thought you had it. Pensé que ya lo tenía. I'm sorry.
No.
Okay. So guys, we will just listen. Well, I'm going to share with you again the book. And we're going to read the conversation. Just some of you because of the time. So we have Diego and Stacy. And it says, Diego, we will use this chart to analyze the training needs of our members, new servers, I'm sorry. It says major tasks of the position. Ah, servers are in charge of handling food correctly and processing payments correctly. Don't forget, servers have to be friendly. I think we need to help them with that. Grooming and personal appearance, they look a bit messy. Okay, let's have a short training next Saturday in the morning. I will organize everything and you send them an email to let them know. Okay, so now let's do it with you. We will listen to Brian and Anna first. Brian, you are Diego? And Anna, you are Stacy.
Okay.
And Brian, okay.
Okay, teacher. We will use this chart to analyze the training needs of our new servers.
It says major tasks of the position. Servers are in charge of handling foods correctly and processes payment correctly.
Don't forget, servers have to be friendly. I think we need to help them with that. Grooming and personal appearance. They look a bit messy.
Okay, let's have a short training next Saturday. In the morning, I will organize everything and you send them an email to let them know.
Okay, good pronunciation and fluency. Just one word, guys. Major. Can you say major. It again? Major.
Mm-hmm. Major.
That's the way we say it. Thank you. Now let's listen to Oscar. Oscar and Arnoldo. Oscar, you are Diego. Arnoldo, Galil. Arnoldo, Stacy. I'm mixing everything right now. Okay, ready?
Okay, ready?
Ready.
We will use this chart to analyze the training need of our new server.
It says major task of the position as servers are in charge of handling food correctly and processing payment correctly.
Don't forget, servers have to be friendly. I think we need to help them with that. Grooming and personal appearance, they look a bit messy.
Okay, let's have a short training next Saturday in the morning. I will organize everything and you send them an email to let them know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Arnoldo and Oscar. Just one word, appearance. Can you say it again, please?
Appearance.
Correct. That's the way it sounds. Okay, thank you. Now, Jenny. Jenny and Galileo. Jenny, you are Stacy and Galileo, Diego.
Okay, ma'am. Here I go. We will use this chart to analyze the training needs of our new servers.
It says major task of the position. Servers are in chain of handling food correctly and processing payments correctly.
Don't forget, servers have to be friendly. I think we need to help them with that. Grooming and personal appearance, they look a bit messy.
Okay, let's have a short training next Saturday in the morning. I will organize everything and you send them an email to let them know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good job. Thank you. Just this word again, only three sounds. Appearance. Appearance. Can you say it again, please?
Appearance.
Esta, aquí estas dos se van a combinar en una y solo va a ser api. Appearance.
Appearance.
One more. Yes. Uh-huh. Appearance.
Appearance.
Thank you. Appearance. And finally, we will listen to Juan Carlos and Mayra. Juan Carlos, you are Diego. Mayra, Stacy.
Okay.
We will use this chart to analyze the training needs of our new servers.
It says major task of the position. A server are in charge of handling food correctly and processing payment correctly.
Don't forget, servers have to be friendly. I think we need to help them with that. Grooming and personal appearance, they look a bit messy.
Okay, let's have a short training next Saturday in the morning. I will organize everything and you send them an email to let them know.
No. Uh-huh. Thank you, Mayra and Juan Carlos. And this one here, analyze. That's the way it sounds. Okay, analyze. Okay, guys. Uh-huh. Again, Mayra, I couldn't hear you.
Analyze.
Yes. Uh-huh. Do you have questions about the vocabulary? New words. Do you know this one? Messi is not the player. It's not Messi from Barcelona. Well, not in Barcelona anymore, right? Now it's in Paris. I don't remember where, but yes. Messi, do you know that word?
Chart.
Which chart? Okay.
Chart, yes.
Chart. Is a sheet of information. Es una hoja que contiene información. Hay diferentes formas. Puede ser un map, puede ser un chart. El que está acá es un chart. It's a piece of information. A graphic, una gráfica también es un chart. Es algo, una okay. página con información. Así, en cuadro, gráfica, maps. Ese es un chart.
Ok.
Anything Thank else? You. You're welcome. Something else I could help you with? Galileo?
Yeah, people or a place within, without order, any order.
Messy, ajá, correct. Not organized. That is the meaning of messy. Correct. Anything else I could help you with? No, no more questions. Okay, in this moment, we are going to study how to use will. We're going to talk about how to express our ideas in the future tense. I'm going to share with you this presentation. And here we have the structure, okay? We have the structure. Okay, Anna, can you read the explanation, please? The one we have here.
Read this.
Yes.
The future use will last the bus for all the verbs to talk about this that will take place in the future.
Correct. So we use will and the verb in the base form to talk about future activities, okay? Vamos a utilizar la palabra will para hablar del futuro, okay? Like here, we have an example. Nelson, can you read it, please? In the future, the example.
Hello?
Can you read the example? Puede leer el ejemplo, please.
Okay. Es el que está en la nube, ¿verdad?
Yes, the one in the cloud.
Okay. In the future, we will have friends from other planets.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. So you can see the structure. So las voy a poner en la whiteboard in one moment. We will have the verb in the base form. We will have friends from other planets. The negative form of this is won't. Okay, the negative form is will not, or the contraction won't. Okay, that is the negative form. La forma negativa, ¿verdad? Para hacer oraciones negativas, puede ser will not o la contracción won't. Eso sería ya in the negative form. And then here we have the list of contractions. Aquí van a ver la lista de contractions que tenemos available. Because in English, that is very common, right? En inglés se hacen bastantes contractions. If you want to say, I will, si quieren decir eso, pueden decir, I'll, you will, you'll, he will, he'll, she will, she'll, it will. This one, the one you see here, it'll, este que aparece acá, se supone que no debemos utilizarla, que no tiene contraction, but people use it, pero las personas la utilizan. Pero gramaticalmente hablando, esta no debería de estar, o no debería de usarse, la de it. Se supone que no se puede, pero lo usan, everyone use it. We will, the contraction, will. They will, they'll. If you notice, hay un patrón, ¿verdad? No sé si ya lo notaron. Es el subject, apostrophe y doble L. Con eso ustedes ya hacen su contraction. That's the same with all of them. Para aprendérselas. Just subject, apostrophe, and double L. Do you want to ask a question in this moment? No sé si quieren que me detenga and you have a question for me.
Teacher.
Pronunciación nuevamente.
Ajá, ok. Y luego vamos a probar con ustedes. Es como hacer una doble L al final. I'll, you'll, he'll, he'll, she'll, she'll, it'll, it'll, will. It sounds the same as will, will, they'll, they'll. Let's try. Do you want to try? ¿Quiere probar, Laura? The first three, at least.
Creo que no me va a salir, teacher, el sonido.
Let's try.
Me parece mejor I will que I will.
I will, vaya, ya vi.
I will.
That's correct. I will. And the next one, teacher. How would it be?
Your.
Number three, la última, the one here.
Heel. Okay.
Correct.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Thank you. Now let's listen to, let's check. Oscar, can you read the next ones, please? The pronunciation of the next four.
Heel, heel, will, date.
Yes. Correct. Okay, good job. Thank you, Oscar. Now let's try with Wendy. Okay, Wendy, the ones you see in blue.
I'll, you, he'll, she'll, you'll, will, they'll.
Correct. Uh-huh. Very good. Maybe the only one is the one that eat. Tiene como que una R en medio. It'll. So that's the way it sounds. Besides that, Wendy, perfect. Now let's try with Carlos. Okay, Carlos. The ones you see in blue. Or you're eating, right? Está comiendo ahorita. Si no, luego. It's okay.
No creo, teacher, pronunciarlo bien.
But if you want to, luego que termine de comer, porque si no, no le va a salir.
Thank you.
With the food. Okay, let's try with Juan Carlos. Can you please repeat?
I'll.
Uh-huh.
I'll. You'll. He'll. She'll. It'll. Will. They'll.
Correct. You have very good pronunciation, Juan Carlos. Mm-hmm. That's the way they sound. Okay. Do you want to try now, Carlos? No sé si está preparado ya. If not, that's okay.
La primera, no la escuché bien, teacher.
I'll. Ajá.
I'll. You'll.
Mm-hmm.
Held. Shield.
Mm-hmm.
You'll. Wild. Dale.
Yes, thank you. That's the way it sounds. Okay, this is the formula. Okay, this is the formula that we use. Okay, you need the subject, will, verb in the base form, right? Base form. And then complement. This is an easy structure. Esa es una de las estructuras más fáciles porque es la misma para todos los objects. Solo con utilizar la palabra will, that is future tense. Ya están hablando en future tense. For example, this is the normal way. He will go to the beach. Nelson, right? Sería he, Nelson. Nelson will go to the beach. The contraction, aquí podríamos utilizar la contraction para hacerlo más corto. He'll go to the beach. I'll go to the beach. Okay, that is the contraction. The negative form, I can say, I will not go to the park. Or with a contraction, I won't go to the park, right? And some of you use it. Recuerdo al principio de la clase, ustedes estaban preparando oraciones con will, ¿verdad? Esa fue la que utilizaron y, and you did well. No to, como ustedes ven, no vamos a utilizar will to, solo will and then the verb. Another example, will finish the classes on Friday. We'll finish the classes on Friday, next Friday, right? Future activities. Can you send one, please? Can you send one sentence by chat? Negative or affirmative? With a contraction or without contraction? Pueden enviar una al chat, please. One future sentence using will. Thank you, Arnoldo. Okay, thank you, Juan Carlos. Who else is ready? One example. Okay, thank you, Oscar. Solo el don't no lo vamos a utilizar aquí, Oscar, porque el don't sería present tense. Solo el she won't. Just that change, Oscar. Thank you. I won't have vacations. I'm sorry about that, Galileo. correct. The sentence is perfect. Who else is ready? It is true, ma'am. And it's true. It's not just a lie. Okay. I will go to visit my grandmother on Saturday. Ana, cuando utilice el día específico, utilice la preposición on. In se utiliza solo para mes. In December, in November, on para el día.
Okay.
Then I'll exercise tomorrow. Okay. Thank you. Just that change. I'll go to the park on Saturday. On Saturday. So that's the use. Now, guys, if you know, remember we have like four different options. Tenemos como cuatro opciones para hablar de future tense. Voy a enseñarles ahorita cuándo vamos a utilizar will. And that is here in the book. Three uses, okay? Three options. When you have to use will. ¿Cuándo vamos a utilizar will for future activities? Number one, predictions, okay? For predictions, we use will. Predicciones, si quieren decir algo que va a pasar, una predicción, vamos a utilizar will. You can use, y puede ser, ¿verdad? No porque sepamos el futuro, it's something we believe, es porque creemos que así va a ser. Okay? It's a prediction. We have two examples. Okay, Arnoldo, can you read the examples, please? Example one and two.
I think a famous chef will come to the event.
Mm-hmm.
The manager will prepare a new training for host.
Correct. Prediction. Okay, another prediction. Okay, the pandemic, prediction, the pandemic will not be over next year. Okay, that is what I believe. Esa es mi predicción, que todavía no se acaba el siguiente año. So I can use will, puedo utilizar will, okay? The pandemic will not be over. Who has another prediction for the future? ¿Otra predicción? ¿Alguien que nos quiera decir el futuro? A prediction, choosing will. So we have a magician here, un mago, ideas, Galileo, yes.
Carlos Antonio will get married the next year.
Carlos Antonio, okay, a prediction. Okay, thank you. So that's the one we use, okay? That's number one. By the way, Zaira and Jenny, correct, okay? The sentences that you sent are correct. Okay, entonces ese es el primer uso. Will for predictions. Number two. This one is important porque mañana vamos a seguir en esta línea. Vamos a utilizar present continuous para future tense. Okay, will for decisions that are spontaneous. Spontaneous decisions. Decisiones para el futuro espontáneas. ¿Qué significa espontáneo? A decision you take at the moment of speaking. Algo que decidimos en el momento que hablamos. Un plan que creamos. Ok, como que estemos hablando ahorita aquí y ahorita digamos algo que vamos a hacer. Ok, tomorrow y creamos algo. Vamos a usar will. We will have a party tomorrow. Si lo planeáramos ahorita, que fuera una decisión espontánea, vamos a utilizar will, ¿ok? It's not something programmed. No es algo programado, sino que es lo contrario. Espontáneo, ¿ok? Spontaneous plans. Here we have two ideas, two sentences. Jenny, can you read them, please? The sentences we have here, number one and number two.
Customers are complaining about slow service. I will talk to the staff. That server just spilled the soap on the customer. I will call the manager.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. I'm going to give you an example. Spontaneous decisions, right? I feel sick. Okay. Let's imagine that situation. Imaginémonos que esta es mi situación. I feel sick. Entonces, como me siento así, voy a tomar una decisión que es espontánea de ahorita. I will take a pill. Okay? Spontaneous. Okay? My internet is not working. Okay? Está pasando ahorita. My internet is not working. I need to take a decision. Necesito hacer algo. I will reset the router. Okay? That's spontaneous. Es algo que estoy haciéndolo ahorita. Questions or comments for me about this? No. Okay, next one, number three, promises. That's will, guys. For a promise, we use will. When you want to make promises. Si quieren hacer una promesa en futuro, la vamos a hacer con will. Or offer to help someone. O cuando se ofrecen a ayudar a alguien, también utilizamos will. I have a problem. I will help you, okay? I don't understand the class. I will help you after the class, okay? Si ofrecen ayuda, utilizamos will or promises, okay? We have two examples. Laura, can you read them, please? The last two examples. The chat, the microphone, Laura, I'm sorry.
Sorry, teacher, I will be there at 8 a.m. Mm-hmm. I will help you prepare the document for the training.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Laura. Okay, so those are the three moments we use will. Aquí están cuando los utilizamos. Number one, predictions. Number two, spontaneous decisions. And number three, promises or offer to help. That is when we use the structure we mentioned. In this, this is the document I sent to you. Les envié este documento ahí en el chat. Here you have a chart. Aquí tienen los ejemplos. In affirmative sentences, negative sentences, and for questions, okay, the changes. Tomorrow we still have like two or three more classes. Vamos a estar practicando esto en las siguientes clases, how to use will, okay? But just for you to know, como ven acá, para hacer una pregunta, yes, no question, you only make one change. You have to exchange the subject and will. Cuando hacen una pregunta, ya no va a ser I will, sino que es will I, okay? Like you see it here. Will you cook? Will she cook? Yes, I will, for example. Okay, ahí están las estructuras. We will try to practice. Vamos a empezar a practicar, okay? And yes, Aida, tell me.
Y puede compartir estos cuadritos en el grupo.
Ahí está, ya. Yeah. I sent the document.
¿Puedo entrar ahorita?
No puede. Ah, bueno, ya lo voy a enviar por acá, entonces. Aquí por este chat. Ahí se lo mando, Zaira. Okay, so number one. Here we have to complete the sentences using will and the verb. Okay, you have the verb in parentheses. You have to complete the sentence. Solo vamos a completarlo utilizando future tense. We will start with number two. Lily, can you help us? Are you here, Lily? Lily? No.
Okay.
Ah, Lily, no la encontraba aquí. Ok, Lily, number two. ¿Cómo quedaría?
I am sure you will have a good time in the training.
I am sure you will, you said. You will.
Yes.
Uh-huh, you will have. That's the one. Okay, thank you very much, Lily. Now, Jenny, number three. How do you think it goes?
The training needs analysis will be a success.
Uh-huh. Analysis. And yes, will be
analysis.
Uh-huh.
Will and be a success.
But yes, aquí le hace falta una palabra. Se la vamos a agregar. It will be a success. Okay, a ver aquí un period. And like this. Aquí está. Okay, thank you, Jenny. Now, number four. What is your opinion, Oscar? Number four. I promise. Oscar, no, not here.
I promise my best to put a good score.
Uh-huh, I will do. That's correct. Thank you. Next one, can you help us with the next one? Arnoldo? Negative sentence.
She will not be late to the meeting.
She will not. Mm-hmm. Or she won't. That's the other possibility. Correct. Can you help us with the next one, Carlos? Please. How do you think it will go? Number
manager,
six.
Uh-huh. Will work hard to help us improve.
Yes. Uh-huh. that is the structure we need. Okay. We will practice now in groups, in pairs, in the document that I sent. Do you have any questions before I remove the info? No sé si quisieran preguntar algo antes que quite la info de acá.
Comments en ese caso, teacher, las terceras personas no aplicaría el verbo con la S al final.
No. Mm-mm. Aquí no nos complicamos nada, nada de eso. Solo will y el verbo en base form con todos. Ajá. That is the only way it works.
En la plataforma está unos ejercicios, pero no hay un will head y no lo toma como bueno.
Ah, okay. Me lo envía, please. Lo voy a reportar. I will send it porque sí tenemos que terminarlo para estos días. So I'm going to report it tomorrow.
¿En qué ejercicio es?
What? I'm sorry, what are you talking about?
4.5.
En el
4.5.
Sí, en el 4.5. Ahí lo tengo.
Ah, no, no he llegado.
Sí, es verdad.
Ah, okay. I will report it. Ya voy a ver. Thank you for letting me know.
Igual en el ejercicio de hoy, no hay que hacer contracciones.
In the platform.
Thank you.
The platform. Hmm? Ah, okay. Right, Arnoldo. Thank you. So guys, this is the document that you received by WhatsApp. You have to complete the sentences. We have negative sentences, affirmative sentences, and questions. Okay, I'm going to divide you and please work on it. Okay, I'm going to create the rooms. Do you have any questions before I split you up? No? Okay, so please accept the invite. You're going to get it in this moment.
Estaba, no sabe.
En despacho.
¿Haciendo Tiffany?
Hi, how are you?
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Yo vengo entrando, pero voy a procurar.
Ya la pero... veo más dormidita que despierta, ya estoy, ya asista. Ok. Pero no sé si no los envío a otro room.
No, teacher, no se preocupe, que entendí que hay que ponerle will.
Ah, ok.
Que es okay. Y el verbo no cambia. Y...
ajá, easy, right? Nada de dificultad.
Hay que prestar atención aunque sea dormido.
Ajá, ya veo que sí. Ok.
So, ya no le escribí al chat, ya estaba aquí, pero ajá. Ya estoy aquí.
Sí, por eso pensé que todavía no estaba y dije voy a ir a ver cómo está Juan Carlos, pero ya vi que ya está aquí María Concepción.
Ya estoy.
Ok.
Entonces, solo right. Estoy esperando que compartan ahí el
document.
Ahorita.
Ajá. Ah, ok.
Ya, sí, ya lo encontré. So, ya, obvio.
¿Do you have any doubts? No sé si tienen alguna duda.
No, teacher, hoy sí está más fácil que pegarle un bono.
Ok. Ok. Good. So I'm going to let you continue. See you in one moment.
Ok.
Will you be 20 years old next month? No, I won't.
Ay, ¿por qué no me bajo?
Will you hi, be guys. 20?
Hi, teacher.
Hi, teacher.
Do you have questions? I just came here to check on you. Is there something I could help you with?
Not teacher.
No.
We think that we understand the explanation.
It's easy, right? Eso estaba fácil, ¿verdad?
Yeah.
It is easy, teacher. Okay, easy, yes. Very easy también.
I'm in shock for the news that Laura said that she visit Cancun in March. Wow.
Ah, wow.
Teacher, pero ahí confundí, teacher, porque usted dijo que era como para el tiempo continuo, para el futuro algo cercano, el will o plan de futuro.
Espontáneo.
O en ambos.
Espontáneo.
Pero si
plans.
Voy a ir hasta en marzo, tendría que haber dicho I am going to visit.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to visit.
Carolina, okay. Laura Carolina ha progresado tanto, me llena tanto de orgullo.
Yes, oiga, yes. No sabía mucho, teacher.
It's true, sí, pero yo veo que pone mucha atención, Laura. I have noticed ay, that, teacher, siempre la veo bien.
Es que hoy centrada. Soy un poco estudiosa, teacher, y a veces me quedan algunas palabritas que menciona, pero a la hora de que me pregunta se me olvida todas.
No,
me
you're
la
doing mente. Well, le va muy bien. Como
I'm very proud with you.
Un poco.
Me too.
Ah, qué malo. Improve, dice él.
Proud. De orgulloso. He's proud of you.
Proud. De orgulloso.
¿Verdad?
Ok.
Voy a tener unas 10 estrellas en este curso, teacher.
Yes.
¿Verdad?
Uh-huh. Teacher, okay. I have a good news. Yes. Continue English, but don't in this group. I changed group for the other method. That
which
no
one?
Payrolls. No payrolls method.
Okay. No payroll. So you don't stop.
For two modules, I continue with other group.
Okay. Well, the good news is that you're not going to stop. You continue learning. And later you can come back.
I'm admit to this group in intermediate 4.
Okay, so you're going to advance more.
Yes.
Congratulations in that case.
I'm happy.
Imagine. Yes, Laura.
In the question 2, está bien que, bueno, ahí en lo que puso, en la respuesta de yes, no question, solo yes, she will, pero podemos hacer yes,
she will be,
o toda la
just
o toda la frase también.
Ajá, si fuera long answer, pero short
y si es largo sería
Yes, she will be in the
hasta party. Ahí. Oh, tendremos que agregar todo el complemento.
Yes.
Si fuera largo la respuesta.
Correct.
Sí, no solo así. Ah, okay.
Ajá, si no, just she will.
Lo vamos a agregar para impresionarla.
Okay.
Son bromas,
okay. Teacher. Okay, guys. I will let you continue in that case. See you. Okay. And congratulations, Arnoldo. I'm glad for you. Hi, Oscar. How are you doing?
Intentando.
Well, everything I see is perfect. So you are doing very well. Do you have any questions for me? I just came to check on you. Do you need help?
Yo nada más cuando son preguntas. Ok, va el will siempre. Pero en, la respuesta tenemos que poner el verbo. Ejemplo, en la 7... No, will be. I will be.
No, just yes, I will, or yes, she will, but the verb, nope.
Okay.
It's not perfect. Necessary. Mm-hmm. Okay, so okay. I'm going to visit other rooms. Okay, see you in one moment. Bye bye.
Bye.
Tiene razón. Entonces, vemos si hay otros want. Ay. Yes. No, no, I will. No, I want. Ahí es donde Zaira dice que es want, ¿verdad? En la 7.
La 7.
No, I want. No, ahí no hay. No, está bien. Will you. Pero en la respuesta, en la B de la 7, es no, I want. Uh-huh. Ahí decía usted, va. Ajá.
Sí, ahí. ¿Qué? Okay. Want. Not want. Connection de,
como está arriba.
I not will. N.
Hi, guys. How are you doing?
Hi, teacher.
Hi, teacher. Hi, teacher.
Hello. Do you need help?
No.
I'm sorry, Wendy.
Will, only will and negative different want.
Mm-hmm.
Is different.
Correct. Okay. It's okay. Easy, right? To use will. Will no está muy.
Yeah.
Muy rebuscado. No. Uh-huh, it's good. Okay, how many are you missing? ¿Cuántas les faltan to finish?
La 11 like hay five. Que ponerla ahí porque solo dice WL. Es.
Yo le dije que está dormida, pero no me creen.
Wake her up. Okay, I'll see you there in one moment. Bye bye.
Okay. Because he's very angry. Angry que angry.
Hi, teacher.
Uh-huh.
Do you need help? Which word do you need to know?
No sé, ahorita como encontrándole sentido para saber si es negativo o positivo.
Que nos revise la D. Jenny, teacher, revísanos la 3 a ver si está buena.
I want.
Ajá. I won't be at work.
La 5 es negativa también.
La que le agregamos.
Won't. Ajá. Because he's angry. Porque como dice que está enojado, ajá, yo supondría que no le va a hablar.
Que no va. Ajá. Ajá. No le va a hablar.
Correcto.
Esta. Tenía más duda. En esta sí, porque solo es como will, pero ¿verdad que le haría falta rain?
¿Dónde? ¿A ti en?
En la 14. Uh-huh.
Not rain.
Solo es cuando, el will.
Cuando es una short answer, solo necesitamos el will. Si no,
el will.
Ajá. maybe it will rain tomorrow or maybe it, pero eso sería won't. Porque es como que quizás sí o quizás no. Ajá. Porque si pone will es como lo mismo, quizás sí. So, want.
Sí.
Ajá. Yes. I can see you're done, right? ¿Verdad? Ya solo les, prácticamente solo falta chequearlas. In your case. Ya todas ya las terminaron. Ah, ok. Well, sí. I just, Jenny or Mayra, no sé si me podrían hacer un favor. Yo cambié mi teléfono y no tengo el calendario de a quién le tocaba ahora la private session. No sé si podrían mandarme una captura de pantalla, please. Porque yo lo mandé, creo que last week, I don't remember when. And I don't remember, no me recuerdo a quién le tocaba hoy. Ni mañana, ni pasado.
No, apagado el teléfono.
Ah, okay.
Voy a ver si enciendo.
Voy a buscar, teacher, okay. Pero se lo envío al chat, please. A ver.
A mi número, please. Ajá. Ahí me lo envía, please. Ajá, porque ya no tengo ningún mensaje. Va, solo me voy a abrir. Uh-huh. Okay, thank you. We will return. We will return to the main session and we will check the answers. Okay, see you there. Hello. Okay. We're going to check the answers in this moment just to make sure that we have the same. Okay, let's begin. Okay, one moment. Carlos and Galileo, number one, what is the answer? The movie?
The movie will start soon.
Positive, uh-huh. We'll start. Thank you. Then let's continue with number group number seven. Anna and Nelson, number two. What is your opinion?
Sorry, encendió Microsoft.
Okay.
It's a I will your friends. Be at the party. Yes, she will.
Yes, she will. And the first one.
Repeat the start in the first.
I'm sorry. Thank you. Thank you, Wendy. And number one, Anna, ¿cuál mencionó acá?
Ah, sorry. Ah, number one is the movie will start soon.
But number one de la segunda, letter A. ¿La que va acá?
I will, le pusimos.
I will. Ahí solo sería yes, will.
Will.
Uh-huh.
Will, yes, porque, will. The movie will start soon.
Para la segunda. Ah. Will your
sí,
friend.
Will your friend.
Be at the
your
party.
Friend.
Yes, she
the
will.
The party. Yes, she will.
Yes.
Correct. Okay, thank you. Now, number three, Juan Carlos and Maria Concepcion.
Hello, Mr. Smith. This is Peter. I will be at work today because I am sick.
Uh-huh. Thank you. I will, you said, or I won't. Sorry.
I will.
I will. ¿Eso sería I won't?
I won't. Excuse me, uh-huh. I won't. I will not.
Correct. Because he is sick, so he won't work. Can you participate, Omar? No sé si puede participar, because you have the listener word. Can you continue?
Sorry, miss.
Ah, okay. Okay, I just wanted to double check. Next one, number four. Zaira, what is the answer? Those bags look heavy. Let me help.
Those bags look heavy. Let me help. I will carry the bill for you.
Yes, that's the one. Okay, thank you. Now let's continue with Mayra and Jenny. And number five.
Five.
My brother won't speak to me because he's very angry.
Won't. Thank you. Correct. Won't. Now, Brian, Oscar, and Elena, number six. Brian, do you have that one?
Maybe what time it's, pardon, what time will it the sun?
Will it? Okay, thank you. In this case, only will, porque el subject es the sun, entonces ya no necesitamos poner. What time will the sun rise tomorrow? Thank you. Now, Laura and Arnoldo, number seven. How would it go? Laura? The microphone, Laura. I don't hear you.
Okay, sorry. Will you be 20 years old next month?
Huh?
No. I won't.
No, I won't. And thank you, Mayra. Yes, I got it. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Number eight. Let's continue, Galileo and Carlos. Flight.
We'll depart from gate 12 in 10 minutes.
Correct, we'll depart. Thank you very much. Now, Nelson or Anna, number nine?
Number nine, okay. Is, pardon, sorry.
I'm sorry.
Yes, Nelson.
Do you deem people will live on the moon in your lifetime?
Lifetime, correct. Thank you, Nelson and Anna. Now, Wendy, number 10.
Number 10, yes, maybe I will bake some cookies tomorrow.
Excellent, thank you. Okay, so far, do you have any questions? Hasta acá, no sé si hay alguna duda before I go on, porque voy a borrar todo. Questions? No? We all agree? Todos estamos de acuerdo? Yes. Okay. One moment. Let me scroll down. Okay. We will continue with number 10. Can you help us with that one, Maria Concepcion? Number 10? No, number 11. I'm sorry.
Are you ready to order? No, me alcanzo a leer, teacher, que estoy en el teléfono.
Ah, okay, or Juan Carlos.
Sure. Yes, thank you. I will have a hamburger.
Uh-huh. Yes, I tried to zoom it in. I will have a hamburger. Thank you, Maria Concepcion. Okay, number 12. Let's continue with Mayra, number 12.
It will.
Mm-hmm. It will.
Be mine in a few minutes. It's time to go bell.
Go to bed. Yes, and this one is midnight. That is the pronunciation. Thank you, Mayra.
Midnight.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, Oscar, number 13, please. The microphone, Oscar.
Okay, this, when do you think we will have our next test?
We'll have our next test. Correct. Thank you. Now, let's see. Laura, 14.
Maybe it will rain tomorrow, and maybe it will not.
Maybe it will, maybe it won't, or it will not. Correct. And then we have the last one, Galileo. How do you have it?
Will you marry me? Yes, I will.
Thank you. Correct. Okay, well, you guys nail this topic. I guess it's the easiest one, right? Creo que quizás este sería el más fácil. I can see that all of you handle it very well. So, congratulations. We will practice. Mañana lo vamos a combinar con otras cosas. So, guys, Ellie was going to stay with me today, but she can't. So, we have room for someone. Si hay alguien que se quiera quedar, se puede quedar porque Ellie ya no se va a poder quedar. Si no, no problem. Pero no sé si hay alguien que se quiera quedar today. No? Okay, that's all right. All right, so in this case, I'm going to take the attendance and then you guys are ready to go. So let's begin with Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Thank you. Ana Lilian.
Present, teacher.
Ryan Javier. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Elizabeth Martinez, José Arnoldo, José Galileo,
present.
José Jonathan,
present.
José Rodrigo, Juan Carlos,
present.
Laura Carolina,
present.
Ben María Concepción,
present.
María Elena. Mayra Moreno.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Nelson Gavarro.
Present.
Okay, thank you.
I'm here, miss.
Okay, Oscar Arnulfo. Zaira Marlene.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Zaira.
Present, teacher.
Wendy Maribel. And Jenny Santos.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. So guys, before present. You go, I think tomorrow you will get the link for the survey. Mañana van a estar recibiendo ya su link para la survey. Remember, we will do it in the class. Solo recordarle que los vamos a hacer Friday, right? Don't do it before. Okay, guys, well, in that case, you're free to go.
Okay.
Enjoy the night and see you tomorrow. Sweet dreams to all of you.
Okay.
Bye.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
All right. Bye.
Blessing.
Take care.
Bye.
Thank you. See you.